back on the show. Love talking to the guy that's in the red chair next. He is one of the great singer-songwriters this country's had. He has done it as a solo artist and in the band as well, but he's also a really big part of the conversation. The one that asks the question, are we asking the right questions about mental illness and mental health in this country? He is one of the 300,000 plus Canadians who have been diagnosed with bipolar disorder. He has weighed heavily into it. He deals with it. He is upfront with his own personal story and perhaps his connection to others with it. And he writes about it as well. Arrows of Desire is a new record. Good job, man.
How you doing, buddy?
We're a little too close now. Congratulations on your record.
Thank you.
Welcome back.
Thank you.
Would you call this a back to the basics, young man?
Yes.
As you get older, and your songs, even though some of the sounds may change, the lyrics are still banging. You still put a lot of thought into the things you're trying to say. Have you found that this is your ability to communicate how you feel has changed over the last 10 or 15 years?
It really depends on, I think, what you're trying to strive to do. I mean, you know, in 2004, there are a lot of artists that, given the presidential election was coming up, right? And Steve Earle, The Revolution Starts Now, he did that record. I did the White Light Rock and Roll Review. They're very direct albums, you know? Topically, over the last three records that I've done, they've been topically poignant. You know, I've talked about myself and mental health issues, and I've talked about the town I grew up in and whatnot. I think with this one, I really just wanted to be a little bit more ambiguous, you know, and employ more metaphors so that people could more directly apply to themselves situationally within their lives.
I want to read you a quote, okay? Mm-hmm. Wait for me if I don't show up. Take from me this hypocrite's cup. Somewhere around the world, someone would love to have my first world problems. Kill the moon and turn out the sun, lock your door and load your gun. Free at last, yeah, the time has come to choose. You kind of coined in popular culture the phrase first world problems.
I did, I guess, inadvertently.
Yeah, because everybody who uses first world problems, the first time most of us ever heard it in the first world, so-called developed world, is in your lyric,